अस्सलाम वालेकुम फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल एमबीबीएस एंड बीडीएस लेक्चर्स। टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज़ रिलेटेड टू माइक्रोबायोलॉजी, डिफरेंस बिटवीन ग्राम पॉजिटिव एंड ग्राम नेगेटिव बैक्टीरिया। बिफोर गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेनेशन, इफ़ यू वांट टू वॉच द सेम लेक्चर इन उर्दू हिंदी, आई ऑलरेडी अपलोड द सेम लेक्चर इन उर्दू हिंदी ऑन माई यूट्यूब चैनल, गो एंड वॉच दैट वीडियो। But if you want to watch in English language, then this video is for you. Now, today's topic is difference between gram-positive and gram-negative bacteria. There are seven differences present between gram-positive and gram-negative bacteria. The first in gram-positive bacteria, thick cell wall is present. In gram-negative bacteria, thin cell wall is present. Why? Because in gram-positive bacteria, thick peptidoglycan layer is present. Due to this, the cell wall is thick. In gram-negative bacteria, thin peptidoglycan layer is present. Due to this, thin cell wall is present in gram-negative bacteria. Now the first difference is in gram-positive bacteria thick cell wall, in gram-negative bacteria thin cell wall. The second difference is in gram-positive bacteria teichoic acid is present. In gram-negative bacteria teichoic acid is not present. Mean teichoic acid is absent. Now what is teichoic acid? Teichoic acid is polymer of ribitol and glycerol phosphate. Polymer of ribitol and glycerol phosphate is called teichoic acid. Now the third difference, in gram positive bacteria endotoxin is absent except listeria. Listeria is the only gram positive bacteria in which endotoxin is present, but in other gram positive bacteria endotoxin is absent. In gram negative bacteria endotoxin is present. Now what is endotoxin? Endotoxin is formed by two components. Number one, lipid A plus polysaccharide. Mean lipid A plus polysaccharide make endotoxin. Now endotoxin is also called lipopolysaccharide. Endotoxin also known as lipopolysaccharide. Why it called lipopolysaccharide? Because due to lipo mean lipid A and polysaccharide mean polysaccharide, because endotoxin is formed by lipid A plus polysaccharide, therefore it also known as lipopolysaccharide. Now lipid A of endotoxin is toxic component and polysaccharide of endotoxin is immunogenic component. Now lipid A, which is toxic component of endotoxin, same in all gram negative bacteria. Toxic component lipid A same in all gram negative bacteria, but the immunogenic component, which is polysaccharide, which stimulate our immune system, this polysaccharide immunogenic component different in different gram negative bacteria. These two things are important because the toxic component of endotoxin is lipid A, which is same in all gram negative bacteria. Now the immunogenic component of endotoxin is polysaccharide, which is different in different gram-negative bacteria. The fourth difference, gram-positive bacteria have no additional lipid layer, but gram-negative bacteria have additional lipid layer. Now, to understand additional lipid layer, we understand this diagram. Now, in bacteria, cell membrane is present, which is present in center, and the cell wall is present. These two things are present in bacteria, cell membrane and cell wall. But in gram-positive bacteria, There is additional lipid layer is present, which I show here in black circle. Now this blue is the cell membrana bacteria. This red is the cell wall bacteria. Now in gram positive bacteria, these additional to black circle of additional lipid layer is not present. But in gram negative bacteria, these two additional lipid layer is present. This is the difference between gram positive and gram negative. Now in gram positive, no additional lipid layer is present. In gram negative, additional lipid layer is present. The fifth difference is, in gram positive bacteria, porin is absent. Porin are those pores from which the material are passed. But in gram positive bacteria, porin is absent. In gram negative bacteria, porin is present. Number six difference is, in gram positive bacteria, periplasmic space is absent, but in gram negative bacteria, periplasmic space is present. Now, what is periplasmic space? To understand the periplasmic space, we again understand the diagram. This is a cell membrana bacteria. This is a cell wall bacteria. Now, in gram negative bacteria, the two additional layer of additional lipid is present. Now, what is periplasmic space? Now, periplasmic space only present in gram negative bacteria, but absent in gram positive bacteria. Now, what is periplasmic space? This is a cell membrane, this is cell wall, and these two outer layer is the additional lipid layer. Now, the space between cell membrane and inner layer of additional lipid layer, the space between cell membrane and inner layer of additional lipid layer, this space is known as periplasmic space. What is periplasmic space? The space between cell membrane and inner additional lipid layer of gram negative bacteria is called periplasmic space. Now, in periplasmic space, if we see this diagram, in periplasmic space, the only red structure which present here is the cell wall. Mean in periplasmic space, the cell wall is present. Additional, in periplasmic space, penicillinase enzyme is present in gram-negative bacteria. Third, in periplasmic space, peptidoglycan is present. Now, the content of periplasmic space is cell wall, which is present here. Second, penicillinase enzyme. Third, peptidoglycan. Now, in gram-positive bacteria, periplasmic space is absent. Why? Because there is no additional lipid layer, and the periplasmic space is the space present between cell membrane and inner layer of additional lipid layer. Now, periplasmic space in gram-positive bacteria is absent, in gram-negative bacteria is present. Now, in periplasmic space, cell wall, penicillinase enzyme, and peptidoglycan is present. The last difference in gram-positive bacteria and gram-negative bacteria is, in gram-positive bacteria, more drugs work. Mean, why more drugs work on gram-positive bacteria? Due to less lipid content in cell membrane. In gram-positive bacteria, in cell membrane, there is less lipid content. Due to this, there is a less barrier in gram-positive bacteria through which easily the drugs are passed. Therefore, more drugs work on gram-positive bacteria and less drugs work on gram-negative bacteria. Why? Due to additional lipid layer and further due to more lipid content in cell membrane. Now, in gram-positive bacteria, only cell membrane and cell wall is present. There is no additional lipid layer. When the drug is come, it pass through the cell wall and it enter in the cell membrane. Again, in cell membrane, there is the less lipid and the drugs pass to the nucleus, to the DNA. But In gram-negative bacteria, when the drug is come, there is additional lipid layer. It show the barrier to the drug. Then when pass through the cell membrane, cell wall, in cell membrane, there is a more lipid content, there is a more barrier. Therefore, in gram-negative bacteria, the less drugs work. In gram-positive bacteria, the more drug work. Now, today our topic is complete. We studied the difference between gram-positive and gram-negative bacteria. There are 7 differences between gram-positive and gram-negative bacteria. We studied each in detail. Now, today our topic is complete. If you like my video, press the like button and share this video with your friends. If you're new to my channel, subscribe my channel by pressing the red subscribe button, and also press the bell icon to open all notification in order to you receive my each new video notification. For watching my videos, I am very thankful to you. Thank you very much.